The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 15, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 9th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Translation: The Super Soul is the original source of all senses, yet He is without senses. He is unattached, although He is the maintainer of all living beings. He transcends the modes of nature, and at the same time, He is the master of all modes of material nature.
Now, we can see these are contradictory. Sarvendriya gunabhasam, Sarvendriya vivarjita. He is the origin of all senses, but He has no senses. Sarvendriya gunabhasam, Sarvendriya vivarjita. Asaptam. He has no attachment. But at the same time, sarvabhircha. He is maintainer of everyone. Nirguna, without any qualities. Guna bhakti cha, but He is the enjoyer of all qualities. So, this requires elucidation, how these contradictions are adjusted. This requires knowledge. Somebody is taking that God is without any form, because yet it is said, Sarvendriya Varjitam, Vivarjitam. Vivarjitam, specifically, He has no indriyas. So if God has no indriya, then He is nirakar. But in the previous verse, Krishna has said that, yes, I have got my indriyas. I can see everything. I can hear everything. So unless He has got ears and eyes to see, we cannot conceive anything that a man without any eyes can see. Is there any such idea? Or a man without having ears can hear also? We cannot conceive any such thing, but these things have to be adjusted. The adjustment is that He has eyes, He has ears, He has legs, He has hands, everything He has got, because Sarvendriya Gunabhasa, He is the origin. In the Vedanta Sutra it is said that the Absolute Truth is the origin of everything. Janmadasya Jataha. So, without a thing being existing in the Absolute Truth, how that can be manifested in this relative truth? This world is relative truth. So there is everything, but only one has to understand what is that everything. That everything is spiritual, that is His material. When it is said that He is Sarvendriya Vivarjitam, that means He has no material senses. He has got senses, He has got eyes, He has got hands, legs, everything, but they are not material. But a man with poor fund of knowledge, they cannot understand that without material body, how there can be possible possessing a body. Because we are accustomed to see the material things, we have no eyes to see spiritual. Atasya Krishna Namadi Navabed Grahyam Indriya. Therefore, Krishna, to benefit us, to become merciful upon us, He appears in this form, Archavigraha, so that we can see him. Because we have learned to see wood, stone, earth, some solid materials. We cannot see subtle things, just like everyone knows. You have got mind, I have got mind, but you cannot see my mind, I cannot see your mind, because it is subtle. I have got my egotism, you have got your egotism, but we cannot find out what is that egotism. Even the material subtle things we cannot see, what to speak of spiritual things. Spirit is still more subtle. Indriyani pararahu indriyabha paramanam manasastu paro buddhi buddhestu japarasa. That spirit, soul, is above the intelligence. Grossly we can understand our material senses, indriyani. Then above this material sense we can understand also that without the action of the mind, these material senses also do not work. If mind is not in order, in spite of my possessing these hands and legs, I cannot work. Madman, just like. He cannot work properly because mind is distorted. So, superior than the senses is the mind. Mind is superior than the senses. And the intelligence is still more superior than the mind. And the spirit soul is still more superior than the intelligence. That is the position. So we cannot see even mind intelligence, what to speak of seeing the soul. So we cannot see in the individual soul which is living within your body, within my body. You cannot see my soul, I cannot see your soul. Just like when a person dies, his sons and daughters or relatives cry, "Oh, our father has gone." The father has gone, but the father which has seen so long, the hands and legs and head, that is lying there. Why do you say father has gone? That means the thing which has gone from within the body of the father, he has never seen. Neither is it possible to see. But at the time of death, he understands that my real father, the soul, which was within this body, he has now gone. Therefore, our vision is always imperfect. I am seeing you, your hands and legs and head, but I am actually not seeing you. You are seeing me, you are seeing my hands and legs, but you are not seeing me. So, even the particles of spirit soul, the part and parcel of God we cannot see. How we can see God? Even the small particle, mamai vāṁsa jīva bhūta, all living entities are part and parcel of Krishna. Just like even a drop of ocean water we cannot recognize. How we can recognize the ocean? Similarly, we, living entities, we are simply small particle of the spirit soul, Krishna. Mamai vāṁsa jīva bhūta. So we cannot see. No medical man has ever seen what is that soul, although they are perceiving there is soul. Now medical man, cardiologist, they are accepting, yes, there is soul. But we cannot see. Therefore, we have to make our eyes clean so that we can see. Just like sometimes we cannot see the smallest particle, but when we see with this telescope, microscope, we can see. It is magnified. So we have to make our eyes fit to see, otherwise everything is there. Therefore the Shastra says, Atasya Krishna Namadi Navhaved Rayam Indriyai. These blunt senses, those who are depending on the blunt senses, they can say Niraka, because he cannot see. He has no eyes to see. What is that akar? What is that form? Because he cannot see, therefore he says Nirakar. Nothing is Nirakar. Neither God is Nirakar nor you are Nirakar. We have got akar. The akar is also mentioned in the shastra. What is that? 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. You know the point of the hair. If you divide into 10,000 parts, that one part is the magnitude of the soul. Kesadra satabhagasya satadha kalpitasya cha jiva bhava savijnaya sa anantaya kalpate. So, the soul is there, but you cannot see in the topmost point of the hair. And if we divide that hair into 10,000 parts, then these eyes cannot see. It's not, therefore we say nirakar. No nirakar, there is akar. But these eyes cannot see. Therefore you have to understand through shastra. Just like Krishna says, yeah, I have got my body, but my body is not like your body. My body is different. That body is described. Sarvatopanipadastap. He has got such a body. It is expanded that everywhere he has got his eyes and legs and hands and all other senses. And the next verse it is confirmed, Sarvendriya Gunabhas. He can see. Therefore he has got the eyes, Gunabhasa, the origin of seeing power. But Sarvendriya Vivarjita, but he has no this material senses. When it is said Sarvendriya Vivarjita, devoid of all senses, that means he is devoid of, he has nothing to deal with his material senses. He has got senses, he has got eyes, he has got ears, legs, everything. But they are not material, they are spiritual. But we cannot see spiritual. Therefore we say God is nirakar, the spirit soul is nirakar. This is our nonsense. It is not that God has no akar. He has got akar. You have to qualify yourself to see the form of the Lord. That is the question. That how we can learn, that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhaktya mam abhijanati javana jaschami tattva. What I am actually, tattva in truth, if you want to know, then you have to take the path of devotional service. It never says that by karma, by jnana, by yoga, you can see me. No, that is not possible. Vatyamam abhijanati javana jaschami tattva. Tato mang tattato gnyatya visati tat anantaram. So we do not know actually in truth what is God. Therefore, with our material conception, we think that God is nirakar. God is not nirakar. He has akar. But we have no power to see him. Because we have no power to see him, therefore, God takes the form like this. He is God. He is not different from God. But he is visible to our blunt eyes. Therefore, we say it is idol. He is not idol. We are not worshipping idol, the stone. Just like some rascals said that if by worshipping stone God is available, then I can worship the mountain. Patthar pujke hari mile to mai puje paha. This rascal does not know that this is not worship of patthar, it is worship of the Supreme Personality of Godhead personally, but to show us mercy because we cannot see the Supreme Personality of Godhead with this blunt eyes. He has assumed the form of his soul. This is called achyama. It is his mercy. That was Shastra says, Atche Siladhi Gurusu Naramati Vaishnavi Jati Buddhi. One should avoid these things. When Achyamurti, the deity worship in the temple, if one thinks it is made of stone, it is made of wood, that is very offensive. One should not think like that. God is omnipotent, all-powerful. He can accept your service even in this form. But because he has assumed this form, don't neglect it that it is true. Then it will be offensive. It is to show you mercy, achyamurti. Otherwise, all the great saintly persons, just like Ramanucharya, Madhyacharya, All big acharyas who are actually controlling the Vedic civilization still, they establish thousands of temples and murtis, especially in South India. Still, Ranganath temple, Tirupati temples, visited by hundreds and thousands of people. That does it mean they have all become fools, they go to see some stone? No. Therefore, one has to become a devotee. Because only devotee can understand that here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, personally standing before me. That devotee. Premanjana Surita Bhakti Vilod. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he visited Jagannath temple, he was very anxious to see the deity Jagannath temple. And as soon as he entered the Jagannath temple, immediately he fainted. Oh, here is my Lord. And others are saying, what is this foolish man? Here is a wooden form of Jagannath, and this man is fainted. But that is the difference between this man and you. Unless you develop your devotional attitude, you cannot see God. Bhaktama Bhujanath, Javanjas Chavin. Therefore, those who are not devotees, they cannot see God. It is not possible. Even God comes before him, just like when Krishna was present before everyone. 5,000 years ago, he was present. In the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he was present. All the soldiers, all the kings, everyone is seeing him. But only Arjuna and few of the Pandavas, they knew that here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. Not all of them. But all of them got salvation. Everyone who died in the presence of Krishna, that is stated, they all got salvation. Because after all they saw Krishna. So that is the position. When Krishna was personally present, even the few Pandavas and the few inhabitants in Vrindavan, nobody could understand him, that is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Others, there is a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Ittam brahma sukhanu bhutya dasam gatanam paradaivatena maya sitanam narudarakena sadhan bijarhu kritapunna punya. Sukadeva Goswami, when was he describing Krishna was playing with the cowherd boy, he is remarking, now, who are these cowherd boys? Kritapunna punya. They have accumulated the highest stock of pious activity. Therefore, they are now playing with the Supreme Lord. Who is this? Krishna. Ittham Brahman. Sukhanubhutya. Those who are after Brahma, impersonal Brahma. Those who are after the happiness of Brahma. So here is the source of that Brahma. Brahmanaham Pratistha. Here is the source of that Brahma. Ittam brahma sukhanubhutya dasangatanang paradaivatena. Those are devotees, dasangatanang, those who have accepted the servitude of the Lord. For them, here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Dasangatanang maya sitanang naradarakena. And those who are under the influence of external energy, maya, they are thinking an ordinary human being born. But those who are playing with him, sadhang bijarhu, kritapurna punya, they have accumulated pious activities for many, many lives. Now they are allowed to play with the Supreme Personality. So that is possible. That is possible. Bhaktamam avijanati javanjastrami tattata tatomam tattato gaitta visadita danantaram. If you actually can understand Krishna, through devotional service, not by challenge, not by mental speculation, not by meditation, not by intuitive activities. No. If you actually become a devotee and develop the consciousness of love for Krishna, then God will be appreciated, God will be seen. Naham prakasa sarvastra yugumaya. Otherwise, he will not be healed. is not exposed to the non-devotees. He is simply exposed. He can reveal himself. When one engages himself in the devotional service, beginning with the tongue, the devotional service begins with the tongue. Now, it is also another astonishing. Service with the tongue. Yes, service with the tongue means if you chant this Hare Krishna mantra, that requires tongue. And if you simply take Krishna prasadam, that requires tongue. With these two business of the tongue, you can realize the Supreme Personality. Chant Hare Krishna and take Krishna prasadam. And gradually, you will understand what is God. Therefore, this word is used. Sevan mukhi hi jivhado swayam eva sphurattva. Because by using the tongue, you develop Krishna consciousness, love for Krishna consciousness. And Krishna being satisfied with your love. Because the real thing is bhakti. Bhaktyamam abhijanati. Patram puspam phalantoyam jumi bhaktya prajacche. Patram puspam phalantoyam. Here we are offering a little food, little leaf, little flower. But what is the essence? What is the value of flower? Value, there is practically no value. But jumi bhaktya prajacchati. The real value is that the flower is offered with devotion. The food is offered with devotion. Therefore, the devotee gradually realizing that yes, I am offering this flower directly to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I am offering the food directly to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is eating, he is perceiving, he is taking the prasad, he is advancing, he is chanting Hare Krishna mantra. This is self-evident, pratyaksham avagamam dharma. This devotion service is directly appreciated. You haven't got to take certificate from others. If you be engaged in devotional service, you actually realize. Therefore it is called pratyaksham avagamam dharma. Other things will remain in theoretical. But this is such a nice thing, devotional service, that you directly understand how much you are making progress, how much you have appreciated God, how much you have understood Krishna. Pratyaksham avagamam dharma. Susukham. Susukham. And also there is no trouble. Very easily and very happily it is performed. Just like the devotional service. One may be illiterate. One may be having no qualification. But the process is so nice to prepare flower garland for Krishna, to prepare food for Krishna, for chanting Krishna, for reading books for Krishna, for hearing about Krishna. You simply hear, you don't do anything. Simply if you hear, Sabaram Ketanam Vishnu, you become devote. Simply by hearing, Sthanesthita Sudhigatam Tanubhavam Manovi. You remain in your place. It doesn't matter what you are. But if you simply hear about Krishna, then you will have it. It is so nice. You don't require any education. Don't require any money. Don't require anything. You simply hear. That is also confirmed in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Sinnatang sakata Krishna punna savana kitana riddhantasta avadrani vidhunati suhit satam. Srihit Satam, his special friend of the devotees. Srihit Satam. Satam means those who are devotees. Asatam means non-devotees. See, he is Srihit Satam. So he is sitting within your heart. Sinnatam Sapatha Krishna. The hearing about Krishna is so beneficial. Because as soon as you begin hearing about Krishna with little devotion and faith, Krishna immediately understands that this living entity is now serious. Because he is using our heart. So, sinnatam sakatha Krishna. Now this man, this living entity, especially man, cats and dogs cannot hear. That is not possible. They can also hear. But it is special facility for the human being. So a man can hear. So, when Krishna sees that you are hearing, sinnatam sakatha, punna, the hearing itself is punna savanati. If you simply hear, it will acquire some pious result. Punya samana kirtam. And if you chant, you get more pious result. Punya samana kirtam. The result will be riddhantasva avadrani, or avadrani, or mischievous things will be washed away. Riddhantasva avadrani, vidhunati, vidhunati. Krishna helps you to wash it away. Because he is your friend. He is everyone's friend, but a special friend to the devotees. Sri Satam. That is also stated in this Bhagavad Gita. Samoham sarva bhuteshu name deshasti napriya. I am equal to everyone. Otherwise, how can we go? Nobody is his enemy, nobody is his friend. But jetu bhajanti maham kritta, persons who are engaged in devotional service with love and friend, for them, special consideration. Special consideration. Tesaṁ satatujuttānāṁ bhajatāṁ phītikūrvatam buddhi-yogam tadānitam jena-māṁ upajāntite. These are the statements in the Bhagavad Gita. If you engage yourself, always, satatujuttānāṁ bhajatāṁ in bhajan, in offering devotion and service. Tesaṁ satatujuttānāṁ bhajatāṁ phītikūrvatam with love, not that official, love. Then he'll talk with you. Buddhi-yogam tadānitam. He'll give you intelligence. He'll talk with you because he's using your heart. Simply you have to qualify yourself how to talk with Krishna. Otherwise Krishna is not far away. He's using your heart. Otherwise he's very, very far away. If you want to understand by your intelligence, what intelligence you have got. You have to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead by your service. And then He will reveal you Himself. Here I am. What do you want? That is the problem. So, sarvendriya guna bhasam sarvendriya vibharita. He has known. This is understood very easily. It is very easily, very easy. Just like a fish can live within the water. He has got also his senses, he has got his organs and everything is there. But it is specially made for living in the water. You cannot live in the water with these hands and legs. That is not possible. It is practical. But the fish can live because he has got special hands and legs. He is very happy. He is not happy as soon as you take it from the water and put on the land. He dies. Similarly, if you are taken from land and put into the water, you will die. So everything requires special hands, legs. Why don't you understand it? Similarly, to live in the spiritual world, you require spiritual hands and legs. So Krishna is so supreme spiritual being. He has got his spiritual hands and legs and eyes. Why you accuse that he has no power? There is nonsense. There is less interest. He has got power. But the different things which you cannot, your poor intelligence cannot accommodate. Therefore Krishna said, this is jnana. One has to learn this. Sarvendriya guna bhasam, sarvendriya vibharjitam. Sarvendriya vibharjitam means he has no spiritual sense or spiritual hands and legs. Material hands and legs. We have also spiritual hands and legs, but now it is covered by this material thing. And therefore, we cannot understand our own position also. That we cannot understand, aham brahmasmi, I am also spirit soul. Therefore, because it is materially covered, but Krishna's body is not materially covered. Therefore, anyone who thinks Krishna's body is also materially covered, the Mayavadi philosophers, they say, that God, when He comes in His material world, He accepts a material body. That is asceticism. He never accepts material body. That is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Abhijananti mana mūrha mana simtu nimāna. If God also accepts a material body, then what is the difference between God and ours? He has nothing material. Everything is spiritual. Everything is spiritual. Even if He accepts material body, He can act spiritually. That is His power. Because material body, material energy is also his energy, just like electric energy. And the expert electrician can transform the electric energy into heat or into cold. That is his manipulation. Even if he accepts material energy, he can use it spiritually. That is his power, all power. So we have to understand these things, and these things can be understood only by submissive hearing and cleansing our dirty things with the heart by devotional service. Then we can understand what is the actual nature of Krishna or Lord. Thank you very much.